In this Cakewalk tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use multi-output instruments in Cakewalk by BandLab. Sure, it's easy enough to set up a stereo or mono instrument track, but some instruments, like drums, are at their best when using multi-outputs. This way you could put individual effects on just the kick drum or just the snare drum. I'm Zane, welcome to Simple Green Tech, and for this Cakewalk tutorial, I'm using the free VST plugin, MT Power Drum Kit 2, but this will work with pretty much any multi-output VST plugin, just the interface is going to look slightly different. But if you want to grab this VST plugin, I've linked to it down in the description. But right now, let's jump in. All right, so let's start with an empty project. And the first thing we want to do is bring in our instrument. So you go over here, you click on our instruments icon. And because I'm bringing in a third-party instrument, it's not really categorized. And I'll just drag it over into this section over here. And now the next thing we're going to do is insert a stereo bus. So you want to go up to Insert and click on Stereo Bus. And it might not look like anything happened, but if we go to Views, Console View, let's close down this side panel here. And you'll notice that we created Bus D over here. Let's rename that to Drum Bus. And then we can close down the console view for now. Now let's open up the interface for our plugin. And we want to go to Mixer. And you can see we have kick, snare, hi-hats, toms, our ride, crash, and china. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 tracks that we need all together. And the one with our drum kit on it counts as one. So we need to create 6 additional tracks. So go up to Insert, Multiple Tracks, and in Track Count, we'll create 6. And then the main destination is going to be the drum bus. So each of these new tracks that we create, they're going to output to the drum bus. Now click OK. And you can see we have our new tracks here, but it's actually created more, so we don't need all of those tracks. We're going to delete the last one here. And now let's rename each of these tracks. So the one with our drum kit on it, let's call that kick. Then track 2 we'll call snare. Track 3 will be toms. 4 is hi-hats. 5 is ride. 6 is crash. And 7 will be china. And now we need to set the inputs on each of these. So we don't need to change the kick one at all. But the snare will go down here. And where it says none, you want to click here, go to MT Power Drum Kit 2, and you want to set this to the second one, and you want stereo. So you want the 2 stereo, because this is a stereo plugin. And we're going to do that for each one of these. The toms will be MT Power Drum Kit 3 stereo. Hi-hats will be MT Power Drum Kit 4 stereo. And we'll just keep going. So we now have all of our inputs set and all of our tracks are renamed. Let's now go back into the drum kit so we can see what we've done. So when we hit kick, it's going to kick, but watch. We hit snare, that's still going to kick. What we need to do is go into the mixer and we need to change these outputs. So kick can stay on 1, but snare we're going to change to 2. Same with the side stick. And then hi-hats we had as 4. The toms were 3. And this plugin is capable of having 8 outputs, so you could create another one and have a separate one for a different tom or a separate one for your open and closed hi-hats. But that's up to you. All right, so we have all of our output set now. Let's go back to the drum kit, see what happens. So kick still on 1, but now snare is on 2. And you see hi-hats on 4, toms on 3. And everything's working the way we want it. And now if we bring up the console view again, and when we play something, you'll notice it's not going to our drum bus. So what we need to do is change the output of our main track here so it goes to drum bus. So you just click here, and then select drum bus. Now watch. It's all going through the drum bus, which then feeds to our master. So now when you're creating your MIDI or bringing in your MIDI information for this drum beat, you can just bring it right into the kick drum track here. So let's do that right now. And now watch when we play it. You can see everything plays correctly. And why you might really want to do this is because now we can add effects to our individual kick, our snare, our toms, our hi-hats, whatever we want. Because an EQ and a compressor for a kick is going to be different than an EQ and compressor for a snare and toms and so on. So let's just add an effect here to our kick. We'll go to Audio Effects, Cakewalk, Compressor. And you can see in the presets they have kick. So we'll click on that. And then we'll do the same thing for the snare. And they have a snare preset in there as well. You'll probably want to change these, but for this demo, I'm just going to go with the preset and we'll hear how this has changed things. And of course, you can have effects on your drum bus as well. So you might want to put a compressor on your drum bus and maybe an EQ on your drum bus to sort of blend all your drums together. You can control the levels of all of your drums by using the fader on the drum bus. This makes it very easy for doing your gain staging and getting your levels correct. And of course, you can adjust the level of each individual drum on each individual drums fader as well. If you use a VST drum kit in your projects, chances are it has multiple outputs, and you should set it up this way so you can take your tracks to another level. Now, if you want to see even more Cakewalk tutorials from me, click up here or click down here to see what YouTube recommends. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching for Simple Green Tech. I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.